Hey folks, you may know that Azure Functions enables you to build highly scalable APIs, but now Azure API Management has a new serverless-friendly billing model. It scales on demand and bills for execution instead of a per-hour fixed scale model. Mike Budzynski is here to show us how it works today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman. It's another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with Mike Budzynski. We're going to talk about Azure API Management. How are you, sir?
Very good. Thanks for having me, Scott.
My pleasure.
So I'd like to start with a brief introduction of what API Management is. It's a product in Azure that allows you to aggregate all of your APIs from all of your backend services in one centralized location, where then you can manage those APIs. You can do monitoring. You can introduce new versions. You can imply security, throttling, caching policies. All of that in one centralized place. We have been offering it in a few tiers based on a fixed monthly cost. But what we have been seeing in the recent years in the IT and software world is this dramatic shift from monolithic services to microservices and serverless architectures. So we have just come up with a new tier that fully enables all of Azure customers, all of Azure users to leverage the serverless possibilities of our Microsoft platform. The tier is called API Management Consumption Tier. And as you can see on the slide, it is fully based on the serverless properties. So in this case, API Management runs totally on a shared infrastructure, meaning that it allows for instant provisioning and huge scalability. You can scale from zero to a hero and back to zero. It also allows for billing, proper billing. So you actually pay per action, you pay per usage of APIs. You don't pay a fixed monthly cost of your API Management instance. So the new tier, it comes with a few limitations. It has a curated feature set, so it does not allow you to have a website and automatically generated developer portal with the documentation of your APIs, but it does have a few other features. So what I have prepared for today, I have implemented a store, a simple store app that runs completely on a serverless architecture. It's called Serverless Pets. So in this case, my store is implemented with two function apps with a few functions. And then those function apps are actually fronted with API Management. So all the traffic happens through API Management to the function apps. It's called Serverless Pets because it sells accessories for pets. So let me demonstrate that to you.
Okay.
Here we have the Azure portal. I have prepared a resource group with a few resources in it. So I have the API Management instance, serverless pets. I also have two function apps with a storage account. And I have application insights and Azure Redis cache, all in one resource group.
So you have no virtual machines, no app services, nothing stateful.
It's all serverless. No servers, no infrastructure around it.
Wow.
So let's take a look at my API Management instance. As you can see, it runs on the consumption tier, so the latest and the greatest for serverless architectures. When I go to my APIs, I have already imported one of my function app into one of the APIs called serverless pets. It has a couple of methods, API methods in it, like order and products, as you could see in the previous architecture slide. What I'm going to do now is I'd like to import my other function app into the same API so that all of my store API is under one common umbrella, so it shares all the properties, it shares even the hostname. So I'm clicking import, and then I can select to import a function app. It's just simple as that. So let me select my function app. This is the serverless pets warehouse, which has the inventory methods in it. So what happens behind the scenes is we are contacting this function app, and we are fetching the list of functions with HTTP triggers in it. And then once we select the functions that we want to import, API Management automatically creates a key, a host key in the function app, and puts the same host key in API Management. So all the communication happens exclusively with this new function app host key. So I've already imported my function app, and as you can see, I now have the inventory methods as well. Let me drill down to the products method. So to do that, I'm going to the test tab, and I'm selecting the products method. This method is supposed to trigger my function app and return a list of products in my store. So as you can see, I'm getting 200 OK, so it means it's working. I'm getting a list of products that I'm seeing in my store. One of them, for example, being a diamond-studded hairbrush for poodles for $90,000. Unfortunately, this hairbrush does not come with API management instance.
Okay.
But there are way cooler things that do.
All right.
So if I go back to my API management instance, there is a very cool new feature that we have just added. Because the consumption tier does not come with a built-in cache, we have implemented a very innovative new feature that allows you to plug in your own external cache, whether it's hosted on Azure or somewhere else. So what you can see here, I already added my Redis cache, which I showed to you a few minutes before.
Mm-hmm.
So to activate it, I'm going back to my API. Let me go back to my products method.
Mm-hmm.
So this is a pretty static method. Every time I call it, it triggers the function app and returns the same list of products. So there is actually no reason to trigger my function app every time. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add the caching policy with just three clicks. So I click on Add Policy. Then there is a couple of policies. Let me go to my caching policy, and I specify the time to leave to 1 hour, 3600 seconds. Then I click Save. Just three clicks, and I have implemented a caching policy in my API. So now let's go and see if my caching policy works. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to my test tab, select the products operation, and then execute it again. Then I'm going to the trace tab, which allows me to trace off my API call. And as you can see, it now says that cache lookup resulted in a hit, meaning that my caching, the response, is already cached in my API management instance. So I don't have to execute my function app, which allows me to reduce the latency of my API call. It also allows me to save some money because I'm not paying for that execution. So that's a very, very, very cool feature. So if I go back to my dashboard, let's take a look at Application Insights now. In Application Insights, I can see the whole overview of my function apps, as well as the API management instance. So if I go to application map, which sometimes takes a few seconds to load, I have my function app here on the right, and I also have my API management instance.
Mm-hmm.
What kind of worries me is this red ring around my API management instance. So let's investigate what's happening here. And that's actually pretty insane. I'm getting 20,000 failed requests in my API management instance.
Uh-oh.
Which is weird, right? It's not what I expect. So I want to drill down and investigate these failures. So as you can see now, I have only two failed HTTP status response codes. One of them is 401 with 12,500 failed requests. 401 means unauthorized. So mm-hmm. someone, either a bot or a malicious agent, is trying to call my API without a subscription key or with the wrong subscription key. They're trying to breach my API.
Okay.
So what happens is these calls are rejected in API management. They are not going further to the function app.
Oh, interesting. So from a consumption perspective, you're stopping at API management,
right,
and the function app doesn't have to deal with
exactly
an unauthorized.
Exactly, right. And then there is another failed request, which is 429. Meaning too many requests. So before coming here, I have implemented a throttling policy in my API management instance. And I set throttling to 10 requests per half a minute. So if I get more requests than that, they are being rejected with 429 HTTP status code. So that allows me to protect my backend services from abusive actors. And one last feature that I would like to show is the live metric stream. So it allows me to actually monitor my my store live. So to demonstrate that, I'm going to issue a few hundred calls to my API. And then as you can see, I'm seeing this traffic live in Application Insights. So that's very powerful. My test is configured to issue both requests that are unauthorized and requests that should succeed.
Mm-hmm.
And these are actually reflected in my live charts. So that's a very powerful tool. So that's all what I had to show today.
That's pretty amazing how people can snap these things together that in the past they would have had to write themselves. You
exactly.
know, if you have a function and maybe it calls a SQL Server or a Cosmos DB or even just a JSON object in a table, you have to ask yourself, where does the caching code go? Where does the authorization code go? Where are the cross-cutting concerns? and API Management provides those for you.
Exactly. API Management is like a central piece to almost every cloud architecture, just because it deals with APIs, which are the common protocol for communication between the services and users.
Exactly. It also had me thinking about that different teams make different microservices, but you want to put a face or a front on it that makes it look like those microservices are a cohesive versioned API, and API Management can give you that face.
Absolutely. So API Management has many more features. I highly encourage all of you to go look it up. We have a very comprehensive documentation that allows you to get started in just 5 minutes. We even prepared a sample backend service that you can just call and get sample responses from it.
Fantastic. I'm learning all about one of my favorite things in Azure, Azure API Management. Be sure to check out the other Azure API Management videos that we have here on Azure Friday, and of course, the extensive documentation. I'm learning all about Azure API Management and the new consumption tier for serverless architecture today on Azure Friday.
Thank you.